My whole life, I've been a controller gamer. I've played Call of Duty, Halo, Fortnite, Rocket League, Apex, you name it, pretty much every game. But I wanted to test myself on mouse and keyboard by playing Valorant. I've never played this game before, so I have no idea how I'm gonna perform. But since I have such a great gaming background, I assume that I can get a pretty high rank within a couple of weeks if I try. So I'm gonna train my aim as best as I can, maybe get some game sense along with it, and we'll see what we can do. They say aim labs helps with muscle memory and all that good stuff. In Valorant, you gotta be able to click heads, otherwise you're not gonna be good. So I'm just gonna go through and play the fundamentals, the beginner, the intermediate, and the expert, and I'll see if this is what's gonna help me get better. I have all my sends configured as well. I have Valorant downloaded, I have my sensitivity all good. I'm just gonna take my time, get used to everything. My mouse and my keyboard's a mechanical keyboard, it's very nice. My mouse though, it has like three clicks on it. There's 12 buttons, 12 thumb buttons. It's absolutely massive, Foz. So maybe I should invest in the Super Light. I know that's one of the popular gaming mouses for mouse and keyboard, but I think this is gonna get the job done. I doubt I'm gonna need anything crazy if I wanna just gain a few ranks in Valorant. As long as I train my aim daily, practice a lot, I'm sure we're gonna be good. Shooting a basketball 100 times a day will make you a better basketball shooter. So if I go in Valorant and I play against real people, which I will do soon, that'll make me a better player against other real people. But I'm gonna start off in the range, build up steps to get to the real thing, and actually get used to the mechanics, see how we do. So to make this realistic as possible, I just buy a Vandal in the range, I make it eliminate 100, and then make the bot strafe just because it's kind of like the real game as well. I like this because I can stand still and practice my shots like this, but like this is kind of like aim labs, right? So I feel like if I add the strafe and I move like with their movements and I really get used to the gameplay just by doing this a lot, so like moving left, moving right, that's what I've seemed to learn from the YouTube videos, reading the little articles on how to aim better and all that stuff, counter strafing or whatever. I think you gotta, like, if you want to counter strafe, I think you gotta do it a little quicker. Like that, I think that was a good one right there, but like I'm learning. This is very early gameplay for me. And yeah, I just do this for a fat minute. One of the things that I read was you're supposed to aim, stop, and then shoot, not stop, aim, and then shoot. Because I guess if you stop and then aim, you're already dead. So I'm trying to learn these things as quickly as I can, just to get the competitive edge over my opponents, but I'm sure it won't be easy. I did it in 162 seconds today. That's not bad. It's finally time to hop into a deathmatch, simulate what would happen in a real game, play against real players. As we can see, got the one tap, the two tap. I'm strafing around, I'm moving. My crosshair placement is pretty bad right here. And that caused me to die from the sage pretty easily. Here I am on day two or three. I'm practicing in deathmatch with the sheriff. As you can see, I get a couple of nice shots. I'm strafing around. I'm trying to keep my crosshair placement nice and high up, head level. And we actually get the quadra kill, which is kind of cool. And that kid destroys me, but it's all right. Here's all the maps that I was good and bad at. Lotus and Haven, I absolutely balled on every single time I played them. Bind, I kind of struggled on because I didn't really know how to play the TPs. My personal favorite map is probably Haven. I spent about an hour in aim labs, in the firing range, and in deathmatch. 3 hours of aim training every day for 1 week. Let's see how good it made me. You should run. So that was obviously a little troll of a clip. It is a good way to start this segment because I kind of was lost in the game of Valorant. I did all this training on my aim. I can use the Vandal and shoot it well against bots and dummies and non-moving targets, all of that. But when I got into a game, I kind of didn't really know what to do. Like I said, I'm new to this genre of shooter, so it's a lot different for me to have to play slow and methodical instead of running around at light speed and shooting people on the move. Also, peep the gameplay in the background. This was my first ever ace in ranked Valorant. It was so burger, but I had to clip it because that was the first time I ever got it. So my aim was pretty solid, actually. It was my game sense that really needed to catch up. Every round, I would clip to see what I could improve on. I would have my moments like that one where I make a decent play, but like I said, the aim just couldn't fix everything. Right here in this clip, I got really lucky with that kill. If that guy was any better, he probably would have gotten a double, maybe a triple kill on my whole team, because if you look at the map, nobody was covering that, and if I just take a look at my map, I probably could have prevented the kill on my teammate. Let me tell you though, some guns I developed a love for.
Find you.
If I was an ass, I would have killed him. The Vandal was by far my best gun with like 300 kills and 250 deaths, but the Sheriff, the Operator, and the Judge, every time I used those things, it felt like I always had at least a kill or two. I played Omen the most since I figured, since I'm a noob at the game, I would just smoke off everything since that seemed like a very important role. And as you can see here, I didn't even check my minimap, and I just got a really lucky kill because the guy shot me in the legs with his operator, so pretty fortunate. One of the key ideas I did learn about this game was that it wasn't really my aim, it was actually my movement, and I learned this from some banana guy who is a really good coach on YouTube, so I just watched a lot of his videos and kind of learned from that. I feel like my gameplay got much better from watching him as opposed to training my aim. Take a look at this clip. I'm going Reyna, I'm using the healing stuff, I'm shooting people, and this is one of my better clips, I'll be honest, but I was kind of surprised I was doing this in my first 1,000 hours of the game, so pretty proud of this.
You're so different, bro.
I'm really happy with my progress, but I know if I want to get to the top, it's going to be a long road. Improvement is never gradual. It's going to be bumpy, up and down. Some days are going to suck. That's just how it is. For now, I'm going to keep grinding. Here's the moment of truth. This is the rank I achieved over a week of training my aim, learning game sense, watching YouTube videos, etc. You finally have it. I hope this video inspired at least one person to keep grinding, keep trying, and whatever you're doing. Leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed it all.
Peace. Light 'em up. Spike down mid. Light 'em up.